bottomless pit. But my aim was made strong by the end of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you hear the sing? These songs of freedom is all I ever had. Redemption song, redemption song. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. Number two, ourselves can free our mind. Have no fear for atomic energy. None of them can stop the time. Allah shall kill our prophets while we stand aside and look. Some say just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you ask the same? These songs of freedom is all I. From mental slavery, number two, ourselves can free our mind. Whoa, have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop off the time. Allah shall kill our prophets while we stand aside and look. Some say in just a part of it, we got the fulfill the book. Of freedom as
times that we are gathered here today as we come to celebrate the life of our brethren Nigel, Augustine, Henderson. Yes, it is a sad occasion for some, but it's also a joyful occasion because we all have a lot of time in the earth. When I say not a lot of time in the earth, meaning we all got time where we all know one day we're going to have to reach this place. And when I said reach this place, meaning the flesh is going to move on, yeah, and the spirit return back to the universe and the source of all creation. So with that, we just want to be here to celebrate his life and his journey and get the ones them to remember him. I remember him in his full honor as we know him while he lived. First and foremost, before we say or do anything else more, our deepest condolences go out to the Henderson family. And when I say that, I mean on both sides. Because in every family, there's two mothers, there's two fathers, there's two grandmothers, there's two great-grandfathers. So we have to think about both sides. So whatever the family and all those that have gone before, we ask the ancestors here now to watch over our proceedings as we get back here to here. Empress Natasha, my deepest condolences go out to you and your Christmas and Father and to all the family. Now for some of the items, you're going to probably wonder, wait, why are we having a funeral ceremony here? Well, the virgin and the family, it wasn't really into the church thing. And once the ones who know I and I is Rasta, you deal with spirituality. Well, I do personally with spirituality more than the religious thing. Our religion is a set of rules and things and constructs that you have to follow and obey. And we as Rastafari, we say free, and spirituality is about freedom. That's what it's all about, freedom. So before we do anything else more, I just want to welcome each and every one in that divine precious name of His Imperial Majesty Emperor Haile Selassie the First. We know Him as Kadamawi, Mawahandas, Azahamaniga Yahuda, the Lion of Judah. With that, we're going to ask each and every one who is here present today, all who are able-bodied, we'd like you to stand and rise as we open and start our prayer. You know, say by infirmity or something that's forcing anybody to wake up. As long as we can stand, because Rastafari, we don't pray upon knees. Well, I don't. We pray standing. We don't know them a half a shoe. That's what happened when we are looked down. We got robbed and steal and got tricked. So here's our journey today as we come to celebrate the life of Nigel Augustine. I mean, like the middle name, Augustine. I really do. Yeah. It was a saint. Anybody who study religion, as we said, we study. It was a saint by the name of Saint Augustine. Alright, so I'm going to do some research this issue I'm talking about. But yet, now we're going to start and we're going to run our proceedings. And we shall start with our deliverance prayer. So for some of you today, I do welcome you once again. This is what we call our rites of passage. We deal with birth to the end of life. Cradle to grave, cradle to the fire, cradle to water. Whichever way it is, because many people go different ways. Some cremated, some get burial, and some get sea birth. And sea burial, and this is how we understand it. But what we look at is the life that we have in the flesh. So I didn't stand here together, turn to each other, left and right, and just say good morning and one love. God.
Good morning.
There for night, one prayer. Even wave if you have to. I say, Mommy, I wave. God. That's how it is. Alright, we come to celebrate this life here. So as I said, rites of passage, and this is one of our rites of passage. We deal with birth. We deal with the blessing and sanctification of youth. People have life achievements. We also deal with weddings, marriages, sanctification, blessing of house, many, many things. And the last and final rite of passage is when we seal somebody up here somehow and send them on to their journey. Outside of that, we do memorials. So when a year from now, the family might want to do a memorial as an ancestral thing, and this is how we are. So with that, we're going to start and say our prayer. Of kings, Lord of lords, the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, elect of him himself, and light of this world, his imperial majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie the First. Jah! Rastafari. So princes and princesses must come out of Babylon. Ethiopians shall stretch forth their hands and their hearts unto Jah, Rastafari. How thou I find majesty, thy spirit came into my heart to dwell in the path of righteousness. Help by night to forgive, so that I now must be forgiven. Teach I now love, loyalty as it is in Mount Zion. Endow I now with thy wise mind to do thy will, thy blessings unto I and I, that the hungry be fed, the naked be clothed, the aged protected, the sick nourished, and all the infants cared for. Deliver I and I from the hands of I and I enemies, so that I and I may prove fruitful in these days. Then in the last days, when I and I enemies are passed away, in the depths of the sea, the depths of the earth, the belly of the beast, and the lake of fire, give us all a place in thy most righteous kingdom. His imperial majesty, I the celestial first, the best man in Asphalt. We love you, say King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the conquering man line of the tribe of Judah. I elect of him oneself, and light of this world. That's right, the ruler, and behind him, it's an awesome verse. John, Rastafari, what's your name, B.C.T.? And before I go any further, we are singing prayer on the drum, they might be near somebody's telephone. So, please, we're not going to tell anybody to turn it off, but if you can put it on silent, you know, because some people have clear work and things, but me, your phone did not come over, they say, not embarrassing nobody, but we have respect the proceedings. The other side, yeah, because we have ears, we can hear it. And we don't really want to disturb, and I did hear it. So, as a reminder. Also, just to let the other know, as you know, just outside this on my right, and my left, which is your right, some of the other, is where you'll find the public toilets and things, if anybody needs anything like that. Without any further ado, we're going to go into our proceedings, and we shall go straight forward into our chants. Now, I must say, we have a slightly good technical, right? So for those who come forward, our microphone is there for the speakers. I'm quite very used to this projecting device and things. So I know for the ones who come up here to speak and the family, it's not going to be easy. And we just want each and everyone to show their appreciation and their love for them to come up here and partake in the situation and what we're here to do. All right? That's the floor, right? don't be with me. I mean, when me and Natasha was talking on the phone, she gave me a list of names, you know. And there are some pretty little names in here, I'm telling you something. Don't be with me, right, if I don't get the pronunciation name right, all right? But we're going to take our first scripture reading from Psalms 27. This is coming from his son, Evianda. Avianda, please show an appreciation of Avianda.
Bear with me, people. Let's get my head together. Oh, it's not in there. Oh, okay, oh, I see. No worries, no worries. All right. Greetings to everybody. Thanks for having me to come out. And this one's for Nigel. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is my strength. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, come against me to eat up my flesh, they shall stumble. They all shall camp against me. My heart shall not fear. Through war shall rise against me, in this I will be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to quiet in his temple. For the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle. He shall hide me, he shall set me upon a rock. Now shall his head be lifted above my enemies around the dead for me. I will offer in his tabernacle sacrifice of joy, and I will sing ye praise unto the Lord. You hear, O Lord, when I cry, my voice mercy upon me, my answer. When thou seekest my face, my heart say unto thee, thy face, thy Lord, I will see. Hide not thy face from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast helped me, leave me not, neither forsake me, O Lord, my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, thy Lord, take me up. Teach me all way, Lord. Lead me in the plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me over unto of mine enemies, for false witnesses have arisen up against me, and such as breed cruelty. I have faintly, unless I have believed, to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord to be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart, O Lord. Praise be to God, yeah? And that's for Nigel Henderson.
Anybody, but we say when we like to sing, we prefer stand up more than yeah. Sit down. So yeah. Nice if we don't stand up and yeah. Break a good advice. You know, then we're there, we sing Rivers of Babylon. But we're here for Anderson, we're celebrating life. You might watch everything we do, you know, you know. But you know, observe and observe all of the things. supposed to say, before we take the next reading, the poem, which is going to be read by Fabi, because I'm looking here in the order of service. And, you know, please, we're going to give them a round of applause. We're going to put this together really nice. Yeah, the pallbearers, sons, grandsons, nephew, Ebiyanda, Avante, Callum, DeAndre, Daniel, Jamie, Joshua, Chrisoni, Kian, Kiefer, Kyle, and Marlon. Have I said that right?
Yes.
Yeah, man. I need to start going to support all of them. So we're going to have a poem read. All right, so the poem here, so that man is a success, is going to be read by his daughters. This is a poem by Robert Louis Stevenson, famous poet. I mean, I was at school and I done English literature. I had to read a lot of Robert Louis Stevenson, I tell you. But yes, his daughters, please give it up for Carla, Lisa, Elisha, and Elle.
Man is a success who has lived well, laughed often, and loved much, who has gained the respect of intelligent men and women, and the love of children.
Who has filled his niche and accomplished his task, who leaves the world better than he found it, who has never lacked appreciation of Earth's beauty, or failed to express it, who looked for the best in others and gave the best he had.
Thank you.
So once again, that man is a success,
yes,
who has lived well, laughed often, and loved much, who has gained the respect of intelligent men and women, and the love of children, who has filled his niche and accomplished his task, who leave the world better than he found it, who has never lacked appreciation of Earth's beauty or failed to express it, who looks for the best in others and gave the best he had. He took for the family of a I'm lighting the incense, and as I'm lighting the incense, I hear the lady and read it and light. This is a very powerful poem.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very powerful. Whoever chose it and picked it up.
Carla.
I'm going to give it up for Carla. We just keep it real as Rasta. Why this man I look like Snoop Dogg? You know what I'm saying? I tell you, he's like, yo, I get like a... He's like a deja vu. You see why? You know, when I talk about him, I half of a combat relationship together, you know. This is why we all related.
Yeah.
Right? Because this is what we call a different side of the family. You have the mix of Jamaican and the Caribbeans and Nevis. But guess what? Snoop Dogg is American from Compton. But yet, him looking just like Snoop Dogg. Am I lying? Why am I telling you? Yeah, that's it. Now, give it up for the family once again. Definitely do tell our stories, I tell you, man. Okay, in our proceedings also now here, so we have another poem, all right? And this is a tribute from his wife, Tabitha, which will be read by his cousin, Bev. So please, show an appreciation for Bev and his cousin.
From his wife Tabitha. If I could write a story, it would be Tile Greatest Ever Told, of a kind and loving husband who had a heart of gold. I could write a million pages, but there's one thing I would say, just how much I love you. I love and miss you every single day. You were a firm foundation through all the storms of life, a sturdy hand to hold onto in times of stress and strife, a true friend I could turn to in times of good and bad, one of life's greatest blessings, the best husband I could have.
Tabitha, can you give me a wave? It's hard to pick points and hard to focus on good things, so we have to commend them where it is. Even because when people make this transition, it's not easy for many of them, it's not easy at all. Now we're going to take a tribute from his cousin, and the cousin is by the name of Sandra. Please give it up for Sandra.
Greetings, everyone. Greetings in the magical name of Jesus. Can you hear me? Okay.
We can't see.
All right then. Greetings, everyone, in the magical name of Jesus. We're here for a special day today. It's Nigel's day. The first time I heard about Nigel, I was around 7 years of age. There was happiness and excitement and joy from all the beloved ladies, aunties. Mum would be running to the red phone box at the end of the street to ring all the aunties. I said, "Mummy, who is Nigel?" With joy in her heart, she said, "A parlour first child, born in a saint kids." It was time to meet cousin Nigel. I was wondering what Nigel would be like. Well, I met the most sweetest, humble, kindest person in the world. He had a lovely warm smile and said hello to me and Mum. We woke up the next morning to a bowl of warm cornflakes, and further down the line would cook us most delicious meals, back home style. The table was made immaculate, not like over here. Let us look at Nigel's personality, the good character that he was. In all the years I knew my dear cuz, I never heard him so, talk negative about anyone, never joined in, no, is it Bacana? Never heard, raise his voice to anyone, I wish somebody could say that about me. I recall the time when I was very vexed and annoyed with someone, ranting on and on to cousin Nigel. When I finally shut up, Nigel just looked at me with a smile and said, "What, you can't go in here?" We had one laughing. I recall the time when I was going through something and Nigel tried to come to my aid. I was rude to Nigel, and up to this day, I feel sad. Forgive me, cuz. I recall when there was a funeral taking place in England and one of our relatives wanted to attend from St. Kitts. Nigel got all the cousins together and we all contributed towards our cousin's fair and he was able to come. I recall one of the most saddest days of Nigel's life where his son passed away some previous years ago. I travelled from London, not sure what to expect, and up the door walked into Nigel's house. And with a painful smile on his face, he said, "All right, cuz, nice to see you." Even at his hardest time, he still put a smile on for others. Nigel was kind, considerate, and always looking out for others. He also spoke words of wisdom with a sense of humour. He taught the youngsters, he told me this at my house, "If you go to someone's house in a can of boiled egg, don't go back there again. Think about it." That's what Nigel said. My witness is over there. "If you go to someone's house, take some toilet paper, because it even costs to use the bathroom." Words of wisdom. I recall around last year when I was in St. Kitts, and I'm walking up a K-on, minding my own business. Family and friends would call to me and say, there we go. "How is Baba?" Lord, I had to love Baba. Baba did sweet when he was small. Baba did nice. I was thinking, who is Baba? It was Nigel's nickname in St. Kitts. And you know those nicknames in St. Kitts that carry you all the way till you leave this earth. Nigel left St. Kitts over 50 years ago. And a lot of people didn't know who I was. And the saint's still singing his praises. I believe Nigel demonstrated love, kindness, passion all his life wherever he went. Nigel has brought us together today on this very special day. You see, we may not know each other and we may not meet again, but one thing we all have in common, from babies to the seniors, we're going to leave this earth one day. What message or legacy will you leave behind for the next generation? If we could take one thing from Nigel to pass on to others, it would be his sweet smile, his kindness, and above all, his care and concern for others, his words of wisdom, and above all, his self-control and meekness. Today is Nigel's day. Thank you, Nigel, for everything you showed us and all the love you gave us. Nigel, may your soul rest in peace.
Tribute, all right, which is going to be coming from cousin Myra. Now, I just want to let ones know, you know, that yes, time and space, a little later on, we'll leave the microphones up with the DJs here for once to give them tribute while we're eating the food and partying. Because it's not going to be enough time for once to give tribute up here today. And I know so this man was well loved. All right, the microphone is on my business. So we are touching. Yeah, man, said, yeah, man. Myra, give it up for Myra.
Good morning, everyone. Nice to see so many people here. Well, as you can see, I ain't coming as quick because I could talk about Nigel all morning. Yeah. You know what I mean? you know, when I first met this man, you know, he came to the door, I opened the door with a spliff in the corner of his mouth. You know, one piece of laughing. That time I was in a destitute situation. Let me just roll it back a bit. I came here over 31 years ago. And within the first couple of months, my uncle shot me out of the house. You know, the cool, you know. Yeah. I washing my skin too much. You know, water costs money, electric costs money. So then I start going around to my aunts to see who could let me in. And I was like the baby Jesus, innit? You know, no room at the inn, no room at the manger. You know what I mean? And my auntie Paulette, you know, God bless her soul. I'm sure she and Nigel must be having a laugh now. Say, boy, Marion, just don't shut up and go. Because that's the kind of woman she was. You know what I mean? So my aunt says, oh, yes, I've got a son named Nigel. You could go by him and see, you know, if you could let you stay there. So I went by Nigel, and as I said, he opened the door, splitting his mouth, laughing. And first thing out of his mouth was, they were the skunk. that's a sinking terminology. Yeah. I said, yeah, man, they were on me. He said, catch up in the little bedroom upstairs. And he said, boy, the way, you know, I got a pot of food there. If you're hungry, you know, just go and help yourself. You know, and from that first day, I thought to myself, boy, this man is, you know, I mean, I never met him before because I didn't grow up in England. I came here when I was in my mid-20s. You know, he was in his early 30s. And, you know, the way how he greeted me, it was like I knew him all my life. And, you know, from since then, you know, he's just, you know, he was like, he was not only like a cousin, you know, he was not only a cousin, but he was like a brother, you know, a big brother to me. Because for the next couple of years, he, you know, took me in and he helped me, you know, until I got on my feet, you know, and everything without charge, nothing. And, you know, over the years, you know, I always paid my respect to him. I would go out, help him out. You know, we do a lot of things together. I remember, you know, one of my first jobs at the airport security. You know, I didn't have a car, so Nigel showed me this car. I don't even want to describe the car. It was an old Cartina. There was nothing right about the car. Everything was wired up and tied up and everything. You know. If you want to turn left, you had to pull a wire. For the indicator to work. And the same thing with the left. You know, so. And he warned me, he said, Myron, before you come to a stop, make sure you pump the brakes at least a couple hundred yards before, because if you forget, this guy now going to stop. You know what I mean? And I can remember going to the NEC one morning, and me forget. So me come into the roundabout, and I said, backside, you know, me put my foot down. I said, you know what, you might as well accelerate. I just made across the island, man. Narrowly miss oncoming traffic. When me come back home and tell Nigel, Nigel start to laugh. Yeah. He says, what did I tell you? You know? You're stupid and you're skunt, your mom. You know, is your mom skunt, you know? So yeah, that was it, man. And then as I said, over the years we did a lot of things to get a lot of jokes and everything. I helped him with his ice cream business. That was the only time he followed. One time he followed because I got fed up, man, because, you know, these ice cream vans, I out there want to make money because that's, you know, that's the goal. And every minute the ice cream van I got down, sun hat, me got a line of customers, ice cream van a butler. When me call him, he laugh. And I'm taking his time to come and fix it. So I decide, I got up my own ice cream van, man. Why Nigel motivated me, man? Fall out with me, big time. But in all of that, even though, he fell out with me, it wasn't like a falling out, because I could still call him.
Yeah.
I could still go there.
Yeah.
He wouldn't run me. I could still open the door. He wouldn't cuss me, So it was just like that falling out, because he think I betrayed him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And here we had, in terms of, like whenever you're feeling down, like sometimes I will be home and, I'll be a bit sad maybe thinking about something. I say, let me jump in my car and, go to Nigel, because I know they're going to get some jokes, so I would just go there. And Nigel's door was always open. And that's literally, by the way. And he'll go there, and Nigel will be welcoming. If you want anything, you could ask Nigel. Nigel will give you the shirt off his back, if it meant, if you need it more than him. And I always say Nigel should have, was like a humanitarian. He was a people's person. And it is sad. But then we just gotta make it a joyous occasion today. To celebrate his life. And by the way, he's also known as Spranger. The Spranger, there's three of us. Me, Spranger one, Spranger two, and Spranger three. Me, Nigel, me, and a guy named John. I wonder if he's here today. Because I haven't heard of him for a long time.
Spranger John?
Yeah. But that came from the Trinidadian comedian. Nigel used to love to watch him. If you all Google it, you'll see. He's a funny man. And his name was Spranger Lang. But we shortened it. We just said Spranger. Over the years, you'll hear each of us, calling each other Spranger. Sometimes we call Blue Spranger too. Derek. So all I could say now is just farewell, to my cousin, my brother, my friend, and may he rest in peace. Let us enjoy and celebrate, everyone.
This song is called I'll Fly Away. Many of you know it. You'll be singing them at Graveside as well, CMA, so that's exactly what we shall do. Alright, once again, ignite it, go ahead and can stand up and sing it. And we'll go forward.
I'm
have another lovely tribute. Again, this is all most of the family giving the tributes. Like I said earlier on, for those who have just come along, later on you'll be able to give some tributes while we have our communal meal. So please, for his cousin Pat, show him appreciation of cousin Pat, step forward.
No, you want to form a group together. Pat and Pat.
This is pension.
Both pensions.
Cousin Pat.
That's right. Both of you.
Yeah. James before gentlemen. Well, Pat, I think you're older than me, aren't you?
You see,
our grandfather, Mr. Pension, every time we go to the airport to send these lot away, right? Yeah, I always used to notice he never cried for the girls.
No, he cried for the boys.
And he used to sob over you lot, so I said to him, Papa, why don't you cry for the girls? Because I used to go with him to the airport. Yeah? I think he loved these boys more than us.
Loved these girls as well.
Yeah, but guess what? Me and Jaffa, every time we have a discussion, who we'd like back, he always want Mama back if it was possible. And I say, no, Papa. They were crazy, you know. Mama. You lot don't know what you miss, your grandchildren and great grandchildren. Okay. Huh? Yeah, when we were brought up proper. But anyway, I'm going to try and say what I'm going to say.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. No, in place. This is Patricia Tosh, Al Posh. I do YouTube and a Facebook, right? And I did all of this, but I'm going to try to break it down. What it is, my grandfather had... seven girls, it caused riots in St. Kitts, beat up all the boys, everything, right? And five sons, yeah? So, two out of marriage, but five sons. Yeah, so Paulette being the youngest girl, Nigel's mom, she used to be looking after me. So, up in the mountains where we are, she's telling Mama that she's taking me, Patsy, down to the churchyard to play. Because you see, I've got a scar here, because it was Cardo, Jaffa's brother, when we joined up for the dates, yeah? And the blood was pouring. But then again, all of we that came late 50s, early 60s, we've all got a scar. That's our mark, yeah? So, but when she was taking me down to her boyfriend Sydney's house, Nigel's father, and they put me out the back, under the tree with lots of sweets. I didn't know. Right? And as I said, I didn't know what they was getting up to in there because I'm about age six, innocent. So on the way home now, she used to threaten me, Patsy, don't tell Mama where we've been. And I go, no, I never did tell Mama. Mama used to say, you had a good time down the churchyard, Patsy. And I used to go, yeah, you know? Yeah? Yeah, so what it is, then one night, we've got the main house, and I'm sleeping in the back. At the very back, there's a house built on stilts with ladders. And I could hear Paulette screaming. I didn't know she was pregnant, so I go out the back now, trying to climb up the stairs, and they held me back. So it's the next day I realize she have a baby, right? And it's like, you have to go up all these stairs, and when I looked up, it's like I saw a star. It's like Nigel. You know, come down the ladder like an angel. Oh. And then when you look in the baby books, you find Nigel means angel. Oh. So to me, he was an angel on earth. Oh. You hear me?
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bill knows who's the boss.
I'm not going to charge you follow that. I think what I found is something that you will register It's not long, but you'll all register with Nigel. Go placidly among the noise and the haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly. And listen to others, even to the dull and the ignorant. Even to the dull and the ignorant. They too have their story. Now, to me, that's something you could probably all recognize with him as a person. Yeah. That's it. That's all I can say.
Please give it up for him again. Please.
Start singing that Nigel means a lot to me, and my brothers and my sister. He helped raise us with my mum when she wasn't well. So kind. Because you know, with my mum and that, we didn't always have the family come over to us, but you see Nigel,
yeah.
Jaffa,
yeah.
There's certain of them, they know who they are. Always check my mum no matter what.
That's
you see? And Auntie Val always loved us. When she came to visit us, she brought us 5 ice creams each. We're like, what are we gonna do with all these ice creams? So there's certain family that just stick to us, you know? And I appreciate this man. So I don't know how I'm gonna sound, but anyway. It must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You was content to let me shine. Hear the words. You always walked a step behind. And I was the one with all the glory. Why, you was the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name. Beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wished I could be. And I can fly higher than an eagle. Cause you are the wind beneath my way. Listen. It might have appeared to go unnoticed. Listen. But I have it all inside my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Cause I know it. That we would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wished I could be. And I can fly higher than an eagle. Cause you are the wind beneath my
ladies and gentlemen, this is Vivisha, Nigel's daughter. Autumn, his granddaughter. I'm his sister, Natasha. On behalf of the family, it looks like I'm now reading. I haven't got my glasses, but we'll get through this. Okay. The eulogy of Nigel Henderson. On behalf of the family, I would like to thank all of you for coming out and joining us here today. As we celebrate the life of their father, my brother, Nigel Henderson, who sadly passed away on October the 18th. I would like to take this time to share with you my dad, Vicious Dad, and his story and legacy. Nigel was born and raised in Cayon, in the area of Cayon in St. Kitts, to Paulette Pension and Sydney Carr, where he had an enriched childhood surrounded by his cousins and his grandparents, who kept a very firm eye on him. Nigel lived with his grandmother, Evangeline Patrick, who he always referred to affectionately as Vangie. He was Evangeline's only grandchild, and she absolutely adored him. She gave him the best of everything, He had the nicest clothes. He had all the latest stuff from America. And was spoiled rotten. We've got pictures, black and white pictures of Nigel with his bicycle, tricycles, and dressed and whatever. But anyway, that's another story. Whilst Nigel lived with Vanjie, he was also living close to his other grandparents on his mother's side, Mr. and Mrs. Pension. Nigel would always call them Mama and Papa. They lived at the top of the hill from where Nigel's grandmother, Vanjie, lived. And a lot of his cousins lived at the top of the hill. So Nigel would have all the fun because he'd be at the top of the hill with the parent, you know, the family from Mum's side, and at the bottom, Dad's side. My dad would often share stories of his grandparents and his happy childhood in St. Kitts. He'd always talk about growing up with his cousins, Jaffa, Adalpha, Angela, Patsy, Beverly, Myron, Carnell, and not forgetting his soulmate, Yabu, who's in St. Kitts still and sadly can't be here with us today, but he should be watching us live stream, I hope. So Yabu, I know you're with us in spirit. You're with us spiritually, I should say. Where am I now? My dad would speak about the animals his grandfather, Papa, had, and the fruit trees, the horse riding, and the general beauty of life in St. Kitts. At the age of 9, Nigel relocated and joined his parents and siblings in Birmingham. Nigel didn't really want to leave St. Kitts at the time, and by the sounds of it, why would he? He was living his best life. However, he soon adapted to life in the UK, as some of his cousins had already joined their families here, and others soon joined him. He also, when he came to the UK, became a big brother to Derek, Kevin, and myself, Natasha. Nigel attended Yardley School in Birmingham, where he met most of his friends, who he's remained in contact with for the whole of his life. And many of them are here and in attendance today. These were great families, great people, such as Donald, Joseph, family names. I couldn't name all the names, so we've got a few. The Kings, the Edmeads, the Stevens families, the Farrells. Too many to mention, so if I haven't mentioned, you know the love there. He was typically one of the lads and always had his friends back. He was a loyal friend. Nigel enjoyed a laugh. He was always full of jokes. Loved to skin up his teeth and laugh, always laughing. And always looked for the funniest side to every situation. He worked his whole life and was passionate about everything he put his hands to. He worked a list of jobs, such as being a self-employed mechanic. And he could literally fix anything. His daughter Vivisha used to call him, "What, Jimmy, fix it," or something like that, because he was always fixing stuff, especially his neighbour's cars. Nigel was a fully trained chef. Nigel was a fully trained chef, and in his younger years, he was known for making the best pastries. He was also a ring and ride bus driver, where all the elderly ladies loved him. It was after he kind of left from Ring and Ride that his entrepreneurial skills began. He began as a scrap metal collector. He would collect metal from all over Birmingham, and Nigel melted it. He made some good money. Many of you will know that he was also an ice cream van. He would travel all around Birmingham in his van, talking to everyone he came into contact with, giving them away free ice creams and lollies to the children. He was counsellor to them as well. We'd need a whole day to talk about Nigel's ice cream van ventures. But we have many good memories and many good laughs about those days. Nigel also set up a hair salon and hair shop in West Bromwich with his beloved wife Tabitha back in 2006. He was one of the first black males selling hair products in West Brom, I'll have you know. Nigel managed the shop whilst his wife managed the hair salon. Nigel wouldn't let any of the staff touch any of the stock, including his wife. So if Nigel wasn't there and things were locked away, people needed their hair done, they had to wait for Nigel to drive from Birmingham to West Brom. Anyone that knows Nigel, he ain't washing. All
Oh gosh, I've lost it. Nigel also, these entrepreneurial skills, so we've done the scrapping, we've done the ice cream van, we've done the car mechanics, he also went into dog breeding, you know, my brother would, you know. He got into dog breeding through with his son, Aviander, one of his older sons. They had a dog called Darkus. And to begin with, Nigel wasn't into the dog. You know what we're like, no bring no dog in here, but... But after a while, he grew and he got attached to the dog. He even built a kennel in the garden for the dog. The dog was living life. Finally, one of Nigel's main jobs, and which he did to, you know, later life, he was an HGV driver, and he'd do long distance driving all across the UK. Never needed a map or a sat nav. Nigel just knew where to go. Nigel leaves behind his wife Tabitha. He has 8 children. His eldest is Nigel, who we affectionately called Little Nigel, who sadly passed away. His second son is Aviander. Also Lisa, Carla, Chrisoni, and Vivisha. And Ellie. And Jamie, oh Lord, they're going to kill me. Anyway, what an auntie am I? I can't remember all these. Do you listen to a minute? Anyway. He has 17 grandchildren and 1 beautiful, she's the sweetest thing you could ever bless eyes on, most beautiful great granddaughter who he adored. He melted Nigel's heart. He'd always speak fondly of her and send me pictures of her. And he was just so proud. Nigel loved his grandchildren and you couldn't tell him anything bad about them. Or about me, actually. He loved his sister too. You couldn't tell him about me. Anyway. He also leaves behind 2 brothers, which I have to get used to now, saying 2 brothers. He leaves behind Brother Derek and Kev and me. And all my life, Nigel's been there. I've never known life without him. But anyway, I won't go into that because we will never get out of here, so I'll move on. He also has 6 nephews, 3 nieces, and many, as you can see, cousins and many friends. Nigel was an outgoing, social person. He had the chat and everyone loved him. There's no secrets, I'm going to say it, the ladies loved him, adored him. I've been with him and I've met some beautiful, lovely women through my brother Nigel, really good sisterings through Nigel. He was a philosopher, very, remember these big words, he was a very philosophical man, and his teachings would reflect that, hence the reason why we're not in the church today, if it all makes sense. He would love to explore and travel to many countries. And when he did, he'd stay there for months at a time. Nigel would be gone. If Nigel went to St Kitts, it was just like a one-way thing and he'd come back, weren't we, Rudy? He was big on his diet, eating natural foods, cooking, boiling up his bush teas and all kind of remedies. Nigel always had something going on. He grew his own veg. He'd always tell me, Tasha, make sure you grow your own herb and veg. Nigel was the life and soul of the party. In fact, he was the life and soul of any room he entered. He just shone. He's already so sadly missed. We just can't believe he's gone. And we know the memory of him will live on forever. Nigel's life was cut short at the age of just 64. We've lost a husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, brother, uncle, cousin, and friend. We all truly miss you, Mr. Nigel Henderson. And today we celebrate the beautiful legacy you've left behind. Yes. So let's look at this today as a celebration of Nigel's life. Thank you.
Wonderful. Yeah, Natasha, well read, dear man. Please give it up for them one more time. Now we've got
got a few more tributes here. I'm going to have to move swiftly through the tributes, am I right? Because we did get some of them come up earlier and then it takes up a lot of time. So I'm quite mindful that we need to be out of here for a certain time so that we can get over to the Inbridge for 12:30. And we don't want the family to get a fight if they're late or things like that. So please, let's keep the rest of the tributes and everything as short and as swift as we can as we move forward. Give it up for Robert Gray.
What can I say about Nigel? Lots and lots and lots and lots, right? As you know, right, Nigel was an ice cream man. He was Mr. Whippy. I was Big Worm. So right beside him all of the time. So Nigel said he might buy ice cream van. So I said, all right, let me see where this will go. So when we go around at Nigel's house, he have this van, this old Bedford van. It don't have no indicators, no headlights, no brake lights, no horn, no electrics. The engine, it hardly can go down the road. So where Nigel go with this thing? Lord. So even the ice cream machine wasn't working on it. But Nigel, we can call him three things: madman, a genius, and a comedian. So we got through. Nigel fixed the ice cream machine, the bearing gone in it, him strip it down, fix it. That'll work. It was working to a point. When you switch on, I'll give you a little science. When you switch on, you got two switches, right, to make ice cream on an ice cream van. One is the thing for whip it, and the next one, it compresses, the compressor, right, freezes the ice cream. So on Nigel's ice cream van, it wasn't working properly, right, so you have to take one spanner, and you turn on the first switch, and you turn on the second switch, and you have to lick the thing, come on! Right, to make it work. And I said to myself, where is Nigel going with this, right? So one day we take out the van, four of us on the van, me, Blue, Peter, and Nigel. And we never take it serious, right? So we got down the road, right? We broke two corner, looking at the tail, £100. So yet, somebody in this, right? So every night we'd come back. Me gone on my yard. Nigel, boy, me work on the van. So me come back the next year. Nigel in a chat, we get one headlight. So we go on and for weeks and weeks, right? By the time Nigel finish, everything I work on the van. You get indicator, horn, everything right. So the three words, right? Madman, genius, and a comedian. So everybody, can you put your hands together for Nigel, because we all love him. We're going to miss him. You know, when you pass, my heart sink. It sink, man. But right, remember the joy, just smile. Today we have to smile for Nigel. We have to smile hard for Nigel. You know, no tears. Smile hard for Nigel, right? Give it up for Nigel.
Even view the body. We are watching everything, but we can't fire past. But we're watching the time. Please give stuff for the children. Yeah.
This is a tribute to my father, Nigel. Yeah, my dad was a great man. It's gonna make it sweet. Yeah, he was a good man, my dad was. He was always there for us, always looking after us, always making sure that we had somewhere to stay, live. Always looked after his kids, always nosing us, folding us up every morning. What's going on, this, that. Never forsake us. He was the best, like, he was my best friend. Like, now he's gone, he hurt so much. When he was younger, he got us on things, making our own money, breeding dogs, brought us shrimmers. You know what I mean? Never ever kicked us out. Only if we nosed him too much, but he was always there to the end. You know what I mean? He was a good man. I'm just to keep it sweet. I had a heart surgery, and my dad, like, when he was young, he was a bit wild, and we got that bond back, and I'll never forget it when I was on the operation thing. And my dad was there, and they gave me the anesthetic, and he looked in my eyes, and he said, "Son, if I had a heart, I'd give it, yeah." And from that day, me and my dad bonded. I love that man to the T. Big up to Nigel Henderson, man.
Growing up, I always looked to my granddad for wisdom and knowledge on how to navigate the world. All his lessons were pretty firm and to the point. My granddad was always there for me no matter what the situation or if I was right or wrong. That's one of the main things I'm thankful for. He allowed me to make my own mistakes, picking me up when I would fall rather than chastise me for trying. Just to give you insight into this, I remember one time my mum sent me to my granddad's because I got into some trouble. Those weeks staying at his, he had me on like a strict military routine where all I could do was read, go gym, and talk to him and Callum. And I remember him and Callum told me that they're gonna waterboard me if I get sent there again for being naughty. And after that, I didn't get sent for bad behavior again. Another story is I remember working on a construction site like 20 minutes away from granddad's, and it was really dusty in there, so it triggered my asthma. And it was really like the weather was terrible, but I called granddad because he was the closest to me, and I said, "Do you have an inhaler?" And he came down with his inhaler in the rain on his bike. And he, I was outside because you know how like black people be late and that, so he was getting mad at me because I went outside, and I came outside and he gave me the inhaler. And I always wanted to be like granddad somewhat. I admired how charismatic he was and how he was always comfortable being himself and staying true to himself. He was a larger than life character who always had time for anyone, and he always loved a good debate. To me, he was a teacher and a best friend in one. Rest in peace. Rest in peace, Nigel. Rest in peace, Nigel, and thank you for all the lessons you taught us.
I'm one of Nigel's granddaughters. My older brother got the opportunity to live with him for some time. He's not able to be here today, but I know he was really devastated that he's not able to go back because that was what he wanted to do. I remember there was a time last year I was in some trouble with my granddad and some of our uncles, and my mum told me all I had to do was call him and apologize. I was so scared. I didn't call him for about 2 months. And I remember when I called him, he just laughed. Yeah. He said, "What took you so long?" I didn't know. I just wish I could have had more time or more memories with him. I'm her mom. I'm Nigel's eldest daughter, and I didn't grow up around my dad. I'm an inmate running back, and so did my children. But from literally the second I met my dad, I've always felt part of this family. And some of my children, he has gone above the stars to do stuff for me and my family, and he's always been there. And I mean, I talk to dad every day, and a part of me still feels like he's just gonna walk through that door right now. So it's really hard right now, but I just really, really love the person that my dad was. The values that he taught us, the knowledge he gave to us, and his wisdom and his laughter. He was always funny, always messages in us, and he's always caring and compassionate for everybody. And I just miss my dad. And on behalf of my other children who are not here, we love you and we miss you.
Nigel was my granddad too. I used to stay at his house from time to time when I got kicked out of my mum's house. Yeah, he would just always try and straighten me back up before going back to my mum's house and then getting sent back there again. That was much of my granddad, and when I did go around there on my own, it was to fix things like my scooters, my bikes, stuff like this. And he would always speak wisdom, have his wisdom videos on, and get me to learn these wisdom videos, which is still in a patch in my head. So that's nice.
Hello guys, for those of you that don't know me, I'm Jamie, Nigel's youngest son. So, yeah man, today we're here to celebrate Nigel's life, man, my dad's life. Yeah. Remember, death is part of life, it's a cycle thing. Yeah. You know, one thing my dad taught me, you can't escape it, get it? Yeah. You know, but my dad taught me a lot of things, man. I could phone him about any advice on gear, advice on money, business ventures, you know, any stupid thing that I had going on. And he'd always point me in the right direction, this and that. But yeah, man, obviously, we're gonna miss him. You see what gets me now, like the other day now, I was watching a YouTube video about something, and I just went to phone my dad, but yeah. But yeah, man, rest in peace, dad, innit?
I'm just gonna keep it short. I had a strong bond with my dad, so Vivisha, that's my son and my daughter. I had a strong bond with my dad. We hardly argued, and when we did, we knew we'd speak again. I loved him so much, and I knew he loved me. He would get on my last nerve, but he was my daddy, and no one could say a bad word about him. He was my rock, and I don't know what I would do without him. I truly miss him.
Know what I'm gonna say, but I have a message of peace, love and hope, because that's what's kept me together and what's kept me striving to go for my granddad, you know, be happier for people. I could cry right now. There's not much I could really say because I have a lot to say. But I'm missing bud.
Time, and we're going to literally kind of seal it up here. So now, when I say seal it up, it's in celebration, because we listen to them that year for them an hour and a half, and we literally an hour and a half over. So I don't think they're going to mind if we have a little extra 5-6 minutes to seal and close our ceremony. So with that, we're going to sing our last chant, which is called On Mine, as we hear the sentiment that comes from the family, the sentiments and tributes that I hear there, comedian, the genius, and many things I heard here today. Now we always say, you know, you see a man's face, but you don't see art. And it's when you celebrate this kind of life celebration, where you see and you learn a lot more about what is taking place with the family. So for all the innocent family, you know, give yourself a round of applause. So with that, we're going to sing our chant and see it. Basically, I come from the family, which I've always been saying for the last 32 years, is rest assured, I have no fear. All right? Maybe I cried earlier when she had to go and tribute with the grandson after that, and I could hear the sentiment in the voice. Just know this, and I'm going to say it to you. Death is not the end. All right? In most faiths and religions, them talk about Zion, them talk about heaven, Islamic talk about paradise. Well, none of us, well, I have never seen nobody get up from the dead and come back and tell us what it's like on the other side. So that is a mystery. It will always be a mystery. But we know this, that something else exists. And I said that because many a time as I was sick as an asthmatic dude and get asthma attack, I used to jump on myself and I fly around the place. And I was in Africa, 82, and I nearly died. And I remember them saying, oh, we have to help the Rasta, I had symptoms of malaria. And I remember the man saying, oh, we have to do something or he's going to die. And so when he said that, I was on my back and I could hear him because I went back for about 3 days. And like the spirit just said, well, if I forgot dead in Africa, let me die in Africa. The moment I said that, I had one of what we don't call an out-of-body experience. I come out of myself, look at myself on the table, and went through the roof, and start fly up into the universe, through the stars and everything. And you ever watch Star Trek and then go warp speed, and you see the spaceship go like that fast. That's how I was going, like my Superman. Next thing you know, I'm on the earth, swimming. Like man from Atlantis and dolphin and whale watch me and me swim. And I'm like, wow, I thought they said there's a heaven. So as far as I'm concerned, there is something else going on in that spiritual realm. This is why we talk about spirituality. There is no death. So why my point I'm saying to the idea, if you're in the bathroom and wash yourself, you might smell your daddy. You might hear a sound. Don't be frightened and don't be scared, all right? Because I was saying in Jamaica, don't be no for frightened. This is not nothing. This is spirit. And spirit love those loved ones. So no spirit is going to harm anybody that you love. They just come to watch over you and check so you are right. So you, that's the most I can say to the item in terms of a comforting thing. There is no death. It's not the end. This is just a transition. So you might dream it. You might smell it. You might eat it. You know, you think here that you just walk into the room. Granddad, have no fear, little ones, all right? Just tell yourself no harm. From the background, you've heard of that prayer, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Well, we use the Amharic prayer, and the Amharic prayer includes the male and the female. And this is a prayer that goes back thousands of years before there was any Jesus or Jesus. These prayers come out of ancient Kemet, which was written on stone. So with that, we say, Kurma, we more ambassador, Hamanega Yahuda, give me a lot of black in us gone. Sure! Each and everyone to go right from the rear. I want you to come forward. We're not forcing anybody, but come and file past the casket and just need to touch if you want. You don't have to touch it and just come and tell you bye-bye and talk to the spirit. All right? And you start now. All right? Respect and love. And please give yourself a round of applause for that. Thank you. Thank you. Palmeiras, come forward, please, as we got to vacate the building soon. Palmeiras, can you come forward, please? Thank you. Palmeiras.
Living without Cause you were my sister, my strength, and my pride. Only God may know why. Still I will get by. No one known that you'd have to go so suddenly, so fast. How could it be that a sweet memory will be all that we have left. And now that you're gone, every day I go on, but life's just not the same. I'm so empty inside, and my tears I can't hide, but I'll
and a time to build up. a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Therefore, what profit has he or she that worketh in that where they have labored? I have seen the travail which the Almighty had given unto the sons and daughters of men to be exercised in it. And he had made everything beautiful in its time. Also he has set all the world in their hearts, so that no man or woman can find out the work that the Almighty has made from the beginning to the end of time. I know that there is no good in them, but it is for a man and a woman to rejoice and to do good in their life. And also that every man and woman should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all their labor. It is the gift of the Almighty. Therefore, I know whatsoever the Almighty do it, it shall be forever. Nothing shall be put to it, or anything taken away from it. And the Almighty do it that men and women should know it. With that, we say, glorious word, sound and the power of the ever living eye. Jah! Rastafari. Kingman, Nigel, take your journey, tarry not. To the Most High, go back out to the source of creation. Jah, Rastafari. Take a journey, go and visit all your ancestors and all those that you have left behind. Rastafari. And may the Almighty watch over you going here now, Kingman. Tarry not down here no more. But to the source of our creation, join your ancestors and the universe and even take your past. And with that, we tell you farewell in this time. And as we say, as Rastafari, they get there with fire and I tell them I know I'm coming. Jah, Rastafari. And now the family.
In 150 yards, turn right.
Sorry, what's that?
Of me, oh, more than I. mountain, out deep down by the river, singing songs of joy on this lovely day. Oh yeah. Three singing birds told me by sunrise he's always there in the morning, praying and blessing the day. Never had the faith to believe in my soul, yeah. Now Mother Nature said to me, three little birds singing a song, convincing me it was so. Now I'm on my way. Anyone come to see me this day, tell them I'll be gone for the day. I'll be down by the river, waiting for the good Lord to pass my way. Oh yeah. I'll be down by the river, singing songs of joy on this lovely day. Oh yeah.
I love you more than I do. Every minute,
excites me. I wanna spend my whole life with you, 'cause I love you. Hey, I love you till the end of time. The others were untrue, but when it came to loving you, till the end of time, I'll make you sing it to you. But I still wanna spend my whole life. I do. Ooh, I wanna love you till the end of time. I wanna hear me say,
listen, Jack, yo.
This is what I told her. Baby, just come closer. Heads up on my shoulder as the nights grow colder. No.
Advice you give us, all the support, all the information, enough days when we come on their chat, you know, and we just think about how we come to this country, and every winter we say we not stay, but we go home. We still not make the effort, but we're there still, and we love you, you know what I mean? Thanks for everything, and it's a Tunji, yeah?
Yo, Kazi, my general, you know what? Rest in power, love, catch you soon, yeah? Bang.
Yeah, I'm here on behalf of a long-term friend. I'm here to help her celebrate the passing of her father. So, we got Lisa and the family. Love to everyone.
Big up, big Nigel. As I said, you don't know how he is already. You get me? As I said, he gave me beer wisdom. Picked me up enough times when I was low. Just told me just come in and just forget about it when I split with him. You know what I mean? As I said, nobody like him. You know what I mean? So, big up.
This man is unblessed.
Yeah. Very happy that my brother got married today. Patience is a virtue. Thank you.
Nigel, down to earth, loving, caring. He look after everybody. He look after. We just call Nigel. I'll be there, man. Nigel, I love you, my being. I love people, but good, hey. My best of the man just drop out of still, you know, but alive, you know. We come and we go. But I ask God, I know God watch his soul and see his soul. He's a good heart person. Yo, all my family, them love Nigel every time. And I'm ice cream van, him used to move me with, you know. You know, let me know that man there. Loads of sweet. I'm sorry, I'm not. But anyway, I tell you. I tell them, all of my family, them know my mom come, but it's, you know, it's crooked to come out because of everything. But a good heart man, and him care for everybody. Him love everybody. Him will fight for you. Him have some nice, decent, intelligent word for knock you out when you come up with some foolishness in him head. Trust me. Respect. Nigel, you're dead, but your soul and your name will never stop. And you tell me, I tell yourself, you know you're sick long time, and you're not even tell me. I come to my house all the time, and you're not even like that. I read my mama talk to you, and I say, Nigel, you need to stop the smoking. Nigel never stop, you know. It's our life. We come and we go. But respect to you and your family, them. I love you every time.
Just want to say that we love you, Nigel. You ain't gone anywhere. You're always with us. And one sweet day, we'll reunite. But for now, cause we're gonna live this for you.
Deepest sympathy to the family, and I just know him when he was younger, but it's Tasha that I've known since, so we've become friends. But no, I'm sad, cause it's, my life is just, you know, and people need to treat it, cause it's precious, trust me. And no one knows what tomorrow brings, okay? Thank you.
You know, there is no Snoop Dogg.
Bless up my friend Nigel. God bless him.
God bless my Uncle Nigel. One love, Rastafari, everything bless.
Yeah, you're gonna be missed for a long time.
All the times laughing and that, joking, talking, Bible scriptures, big up myself, you get me. He worked on the bins. He used to ride his bike 3 a.m.
Ring and ride.
You get me? He was on it, man. He was grafting.
Yeah, man, good man, he's gonna be missed.
To the family and all respect, Anna.
Jealous of the rain that falls upon your skin. It's closer than my hands have been. I'm jealous of the rain. I'm jealous of the wind that ripples through your clothes. It's closer than your shadow. Oh, I'm jealous of the wind. 'Cause I wished you the best of all this world could give. And I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive. But I always thought you'd come back. Tell me all you found was heartbreak and misery. It's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. Jealous of the nights that I don't spend with you. I'm wondering who you lay next to. Oh, I'm jealous of the night. I'm jealous of the love. Love that wasn't here, gone for someone else to share. Oh, I'm jealous of the love. 'Cause I wished you the best of all this world could give. And I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive. But I always thought you'd come back. Tell me all you found me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me. As I sink in the sand, watch you slip through my hands. Oh, as I die here another day, yeah. 'Cause all I do is cry behind the smile. I wish you the best of all this world could give. And I told you when you left me, there's nothing to forgive. But I always thought you'd come back.
And I'm ripping in the sky. Yeah.